Welcome back, everyone. If you're looking to serve something a little bit different and a little bit unexpected this Thanksgiving, you'll appreciate what my next guest has to offer. He's the chef of New York City's Public Restaurant and the newly opened Saxton and Parole. Please welcome Chef Brad Farmerie. Welcome.
Hi, thank you.
So now, what does Saxton and what does the name mean, Saxton and Parole?
The name Saxton and Parole comes from two racehorses from about 100 years ago, and they were stabled down in the Bowery, right where we are.
So, oh, that's nice.
Piece of history.
Yeah, great. What kind of horses? You don't know.
I know. I'm going to leave that to you, Martha.
but this recipe uses kumquats, one of my favorite citrus fruits. So good for you, too. So full of vitamin C.
I love them. You can eat them raw, but I love them cooked as well. And you have a kumquat tree, don't you?
I do, and it's loaded with kumquats.
Bring them all the time.
It sort of produces fruit twice a year.
Wow.
Yeah, I love them.
So this is a perfect time of the year for them.
But they have lots of seeds.
Lots of seeds. And actually, the seeds are full of pectin, which makes sauces thicken and can turn into jam. So we want to make sure that we save those.
So we're going to use them?
Yep. You're diligently seeding those for me, which I appreciate.
So you need a pound of those, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, so we have about a pound. And if you can actually put the seeds in here.
Oh, I will.
We'll wrap those up and add them to our final mix.
Oh, that's good. I see what you're doing.
Yeah.
So you're cooking with them.
Yep. And we want to add some layers of exotic flavor. You know, I think Thanksgiving can be a little bit monotone, a little bit bland. So we want to put some green cardamom and cloves in with it as well. And because they're so beautiful, I have star anise, which will give that great licorice flavor.
Yes.
And that we won't hide. And cinnamon stick. A bit of chili. And this I use Aleppo chili, which is a nice sun-dried, beautiful flavor.
Should I tie this up into a little pouch?
Yes, please, please. And then also I think a very important thing is fresh ginger. I think cranberry sauce can taste very sweet or very sour, sort of one or the other. So I think ginger will give it that spice.
Are you serving Thanksgiving at the restaurants?
Well, usually my big Thanksgiving meal is the day before. We get all the employees from both restaurants, so about 120 people the day before, and
we
make it. Big family meal, so I think that's my extended family.
So you're closed on Thanksgiving?
This year we're actually opening at Saxton Parole, so for the first time, so I'm taking my...
That goes right in?
Right in. My family and my extended family all getting together at Saxton Parole, so I'm excited because it's all dishes I would make at home anyway, but I don't have to clean up.
Aha. So, 4 cups of freshly squeezed orange juice,
Squeezed orange juice. A quarter teaspoon of salt, which actually allows you to use less sugar. It brings out that sweetness.
And then the sugar, too?
And the sugar, too.
2.5 cups of sugar.
Yep.
Okay.
And so that's going to go ahead and cook down for about an hour, hour and a half. And it seems like a long time, but at the same time, you really do no work. Turn on the TV, watch your show, and come back as soon
as
it's...
this is what you have.
Yeah,
really
translucent and beautiful.
Look at the kumquats. Look what happens to the kumquats.
Amazing, amazing.
So gorgeous,
yeah.
Okay.
So if I can get you just to throw the pound and a half of cranberries in
into
there.
Into here?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. And then we'll go ahead and cook that just until the cranberries burst a little bit. So that's going to take about 10 minutes.
Oh, so that is a beautiful relish.
Yeah.
Yum.
It's really, really nice. And we'll get back to that in a little bit. But for my Brussels sprouts, I have cooked some palm sugar. And palm sugar is a great Southeast Asian flavor. A lot of people haven't used it. Have you used it before?
I have. I have that in my pantry. Yes, I do.
So you can chop that up.
It's very strong sugar.
Very strong sugar, but it gives a nice caramely flavor.
It's not like brown. It's not like brown sugar. It's much stronger tasting, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So we just add water and sugar, bring it up to about 310 degrees. So we use
and that's the syrup that comes, right?
Yeah, it's amazing. I'm going to get you a step back because I'm throwing chilies, lime, and fish sauce in there.
Ooh. Oh, so this has a little bit of an unusual flavor.
It does, and yet it's going to taste like...
What was that? What was that last thing you just
White miso. White miso. It's going to taste like something you've never had before.
Because for the aroma just makes me, like, choke up. It's funny.
In a good way, right?
Not just of that. Any chilies, cooked chilies, might start me coughing.
So this is done over here, and we get this nice, thick...
But look at this. These are the cranberries with the kumquats. Oh, these are so pretty.
Yeah, that actually is incredible. That's one of the recipes people ask me for all the time. So this is done. I'm just going to throw a little cilantro in with my chili caramel and put those with Brussels sprouts. So, I'm going to go ahead and the Brussels sprouts were done in the oven at 425.
Just dry?
Just a little bit of olive oil, a little bit of salt.
Taste.
I think very important that you make sure that you char them on the outside or else it really can taste not that amazing.
And this goes on?
Yep. Yeah.
Mm.
So you get that nice, shiny, chili, sweet, sour, spicy. It's everything you want out of Thanksgiving but never get.
Oh, I'm gonna try that.
Go ahead and lay this something out for you.
I can't wait. Very unusual.
If you don't mind, I'll throw a bit of...
You bet I want it. Yeah. I don't mind at all. Look how pretty this is.
Truth is in the tasting.
Really good.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Really good.
Thank you very much.
Very interesting take on two old-fashioned Thanksgiving favorites. And we're going to be right back with a new idea for your dessert table. Yeah, these are so good.
Thank you.
Well, if you're looking for a change from the traditional pumpkin pie, Brad Farmerie is back to share a recipe for pumpkin mousse cheesecake, which was your mom's?
It is my mother's. I call it Linda Farmerie's famous pumpkin mousse cheesecake. She really, anytime I give this to anybody, they always want the recipe and they refuse to eat regular pumpkin pie after that. So
okay, well, I'm
take
ready.
My I'm, word for it.
I'm
you will
ready
too.
To taste.
Great.
So I've made a graham cracker crust out of graham crackers, sugar, and butter.
Yep. Yeah.
Okay, so the simple... traditional graham cracker crust.
And yeah, you can use a fork or a spatula or even your hands if
you're... Do you know that my mom had a cheesecake too with a sour cream topping that she was famous for?
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
She got her mother's together?
Yeah. Well, I wish we could. We can't.
So we're going to go ahead and press that in. And over here we've got...
Just up the sides or just on the bottom?
Well, I think just on the bottom. And this can go into a quiche mold or into a springform pan or into a pie pan, whatever shape you like.
Okay.
For me, this just...
the squares work, right?
It does, and it's just a taste of home, so...
Now, do you pre-bake this?
I don't.
Oh,
I don't. We're
going
to throw on a cheesecake layer, which is just one block of Philadelphia cream cheese.
Okay.
Two eggs and some sugar.
Oh, that good old Philadelphia cream cheese.
You know it, yeah.
And don't get the fat-free kind.
Please don't.
No.
Please don't.
And don't...
It's Thanksgiving, come on.
Yes.
If you need less calories, just whisk it by hand.
It doesn't taste as good, right?
It definitely does not, yeah. So we'll go ahead and whip this up until it gets nice and smooth and frothy. And I think the best thing about this and the best thing about any of my Thanksgiving recipes is almost all of them can be done the day ahead. You know, Thanksgiving
is important.
It's about spending time with your loved ones and your family. So you should not be running around like a headless chicken. You should be spending time.
Headless turkeys.
Headless turkey, to be fair. I'm not quite sure how this works.
Oh, here, it lifts up. No, you have to unlock it. Okay.
See, I'm still learning.
It's not quite mixed, but
we'll give that
add
a quick
other things to it.
A quick once over.
That's not in there tight. Okay. So should I mix it a little bit more?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Just until it's nice and frothy.
Okay.
And then, yeah, that will go on top. And we preheated our oven to 350 degrees.
So no pumpkin goes in this. This
no.
is the cheesecake part.
Cheesecake.
Okay. So I'll spread that. You want to make
you.
The cheesecake part?
Yeah.
And I mean the pumpkin part.
Yeah, so the pumpkin we use, good old-fashioned canned pumpkin, just like everybody does. Although the first time I made this was in London, and there was no canned pumpkin, and so I had to roast pumpkins whole, and it was a disaster. So
no, but it was good, wasn't it?
It was good, but this is plain and simple and quite easy. So we've taken canned pumpkin, and we're going to add milk.
Canned pumpkin is one of the few cans I open because it's pretty much a stable, simple ingredient.
It is. It is. It's consistent too. And so we're going to add half a cup of sugar.
Does it matter that I have a few lumps of cheese in here?
I'm going to say no, only because we're friends. But
yes.
if you worked for me, Martha, it might be a different
you
story.
You mixed it.
I know. So I'm going to add three egg yolks.
You rushed me on my own show.
Not many people can say that, trust me. And a quarter teaspoon of salt.
Okay.
And I'm going to go ahead and mix this up. So that will go into the oven. 350 degrees.
Oh, by itself?
Yep.
Oh,
for 20 minutes.
Okay, so we have one that's already baked.
Yeah. And so this pumpkin mixture, as soon as I started making this, my son always says cinnamon because it's got that great traditional cinnamon smell. And this goes over a double boiler. Basically, it's going to cook for about 8 minutes, just until those egg yolks start to thicken up a little bit.
So is this one done enough?
That is. It's beautiful. You can see it's thick. It's actually gone a little bit more opaque. And then you can add the gelatin, which is...
Right while it's hot?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, it has been softened with a bit of water.
Oh, okay.
And then we're going to go ahead and whisk that just until it incorporates. And then it gets pulled off to room temperature.
Oh, and this changes the consistency totally.
Yeah. And once it goes to room temperature, it will be... It looks a bit thin there, but once it goes to room temperature, it will thicken right up to something a little bit more like this.
I see. Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so here we've made a meringue. This might seem complicated, but at the end of the day, you can make this in about half an hour, start to finish, and then your whole day is free the next day. How's that taste so far?
Good. So this is the baked cheese mixture.
Yep. Cheesecake, pumpkin mousse.
Yes, with you can see the crust on the bottom.
So we're going to go ahead
So that goes into here?
Yeah, I don't want to rush you, though, Martha, this time.
Don't worry.
I learned my lesson. So we're going to go ahead and actually, if this comes off...
Yeah, you can shake that off.
I kind of like to just use this to mix it in as well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, if you can get that for me, it'd be great.
I certainly can. Okay, so we want to refrigerate. Once it's baked, you want to refrigerate it, right?
Yep. Yeah, so this pumpkin mousse will go on, and you can refrigerate it overnight.
Oh, so this doesn't get baked now?
No.
Oh,
no.
Okay.
Yeah, at least 8 hours. But overnight is best. So yeah, we can incorporate air and just, you know, I know at this point all the pastry chefs of the world will tell you don't mix it too much, but my mother's been doing this for almost 40 years
and she'll
tell you differently. She does not, and I love her even more for it. So she does not want to be in the kitchen with me, that's for sure. I think we both appreciate each other's cooking, but I think she's very set in her ways, as am I.
Oh, so, really?
Yeah, yeah. So I'll go ahead and pour this over top.
Okay.
Actually, if I tilt it and you can, there you go.
This looks so good.
Yeah, this really is amazing. I think we're doing our country a favor by sharing this recipe.
And because pumpkin is indigenous to our, to us too.
This will be a memorable one. Great way to end a long Thanksgiving meal.
So, okay.
Much lighter.
So just,
and
nice
yeah,
and,
you can
nice
even
and
just
flat.
Tilt it and shake it and whatever gets into
Level
all the
it
corners.
Out.
There you go. You can even leave a bit of texture on top if you like it. Kind of like that rustic look.
Mm-hmm. So don't we have a piece for me to taste?
Oh, yes, we do. And so you can do creme fraiche, you can do yogurt, you can do whatever you want on the side.
But look how pretty it is. It looks like striped.
Yeah, it's
very pretty.
It really is pretty amazing. And. And I, as I said, to eat is to love it. That's the way that...
It's actually really good.
Thank you.
I think I'll serve this on my Thanksgiving table also, Brad.
Please do.
Thanks to you. This is very nice.
Thank
and for
you.
Recipe help and expert advice, tune into Martha Stewart Living Radio's 5th annual Thanksgiving hotline from the 21st today to the 23rd from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. I'll be answering your calls today from 4 to 5. Brad will be on Wednesday, right?
Wednesday, yep.
Wednesday from 4 to 5 Eastern Time on Martha Stewart Living Radio, Sirius XM Channel 110. So good.
If you're waking up with a